I have a question for you. Kama nakuwekea mayai sasa, usijali, usijali kasichana. Usijali, nakuwekea mayai. Don't beat me. Najua unataka kulalia, sinajua unataka kulalia. So we are about to go deep. Okay, we are about to go really deep. So it's 4 p.m. So those who know the astrological time we are can tell you what hour.
No one knows the day of the time that he was going to come. The son of man.
The descended son, not the father, but the son, the descended son, the son of man. So, nataka kuwekea kuku nyasi ilalie hapa mayai. Nyasi, nakuletea mayai, wacha fujo. Chani kuletea matumbe. Nakuletea matumbe. Wewe, kuja hapa wewe. Huyu ndiye the dancing chicken. This is the dancing chicken. Okay? This is the dancing chicken. If you saw the dancing chicken, this is the dunking chicken. Wanasemanga, be as wise as a dove and wise as a serpent. So we don't have a dove, we have a chicken. Tiga mavu kumere. Dancing chicken. He's dancing. So now, ingia huko urare. Na utachapwa huko umeingia kulala. Utachapwa na huyo mwera sistako. Juu ya mayai. Wacha tuwekee mayai. So now, I have heard a story. I have heard that you have chosen the date 8-8 to hold your... oh shit. This is not cool at all. Sasa hii, I'll get you. Nitakushika. So, a cat, my cat has imemwaga mushrooms. Zenye zilikuwa zina dry. So, ashajua kwenye naziandika. You know, najua hizi cats. Najua these animals are GMO. Pets of nowadays are GMOs. There's no way you are going to have a dog that can fit in a bag. That is a GMO piece of dog. Hiyo naita chihuahua. Whatever you are calling a chihuahua, that's a GMO. So before you think that GMO is only in crops, understand even your cows, they have already been... Nini janza saizi? Remember these things, akina Kenya Agricultural Research Institute, Ministry of Agriculture, even before they became authorities, when they were ministries of agriculture, they were still doing... whatever, what do we call it? Experiments with your cash crops or your crops. Otherwise, how did they know that your soil is good for tea or coffee? Na mkuwa mnapanda hizo vitu. You know, you have to think, You have to think. So don't always be dumb. Because wewe, saizi, unenu unapanda kitungu. Saizi, wewe unatoka hapa, unenu unapanda kitungu hapa, kunaitu wache, hapa kinajiladu wanalima. Izo saidi za kiseria na huko. Already wewe, unaenda unapanda kitungu. Saizi ukiingia TikTok, everyone is complaining. Everyone is complaining, oh, kitungu, oh, bei imeanguka, oh, labda ni ya Tanzania. But each and every person mwenye anapanda kitungu, ni wale watu sikuizi wanachukua. The first thing they do ni soil analysis. Ukiona mtu anapanda kitungu, ujue kitu ya kwanza amefanyua soil analysis. Amechukua mchanga, amepeleka kwa lab, okay? Na akambue mchanga ni mzuri na let's collect the mushrooms as we finish this story. So anaenda anapeleka mchanga kwa lab, anaambiwa hii mchanga iko sawa na nini? Iko sawa na kupanda kama ni kitunguu. So by default, before you start thinking that GMO has started today, you have to follow the practice. Where did this practice come from? How far back did you have what you are calling a ministry of agriculture? how old is Kenya Agricultural Research Institute? These things we are calling institutes before you call them authority. Because, for example, the next government that is going to come in after this, you know, the IBs, of course, when you are spilling wisdom, the IBs, the bird has to pass. Otherwise, ingepita mapema. The IBs or the plane. Sasa zimekuja zote. The IBs na ndege. Shout out to higher minds. Now, you're now tapped into higher minds. Aldebaran moon. Or what you call Venusian energy. Okay, I'm a Venusian. Oh, I came through that Aldebaran shadow, which is Archangel Michael. It doesn't mean that I'm any of those things. You know, it's just a passage. So, when you understand that this is what you are doing today, wewe, unaenda unachukua nini, unaenda unachukua mchanga, unapeleka labu, unaangaliwa ni unambiwa, panda kitungu, hii mchanga yiko sawa. So today, you are looking at the soil in the lab, But whichever way it looks like, even back in the days, they were still looking for favorable places to settle. That is why wana decide, hapa ni pyrethrum, hapa ni hii, juu wamejaribu mchanga, hapa imekataa. The same way they did in Karen. Karen walikuwa mepanda tea. So that lady, the name Karen, if you go to the Karen Brixen Museum, she had settled there to cultivate coffee. Karen. Na hii kufanya vizuri sana her story. So that is why we don't have coffee on that side, but we have coffee on Kiambu Road. Ile side ingine ukienda huko Roiru na hizo sides. Mboi Kamete na huko Kamete Road. So, you have to understand the practice, which you're supposed to see for yourself. Wewe ujionee, unaenda inje, unakaa inje, unajionea. The way God wanted you to see it and come up with your own interpretation and utilize that to make it in the world. But now, since we have other people who have crafted how to take that energy away from you. For example, we are going through we say the sun in Leo. We are about to go through the that story, the Osiris, the Orion, the 8-8 portal, na vitu kama hizo. But you are going to miss it because all your eyes will be on Olympics. So instead of shining your own lion of Judah or understanding that it's important for that portal, hiyo mnasemanga inakuanga 8 August, you do not miss it. But it's not for one day. It's not for one day. It's a whole degree. Okay? It's a whole degree that you have to pay attention to. So the people who practice these degrees highest, you know them, wanazitanga 33, whatever they are, ni Mason, they know how to create using stones, na vitu kama hizo. They come up with their own holidays to take the energy from you. So wewe, instead of lighting your own torch, unaenda kulight the torch of the Olympics, where they make you now compete against each other. Instead of focusing, and even this energy doesn't mean that it should be such a big idea, because everyone is supposed to come into it without even... even most of you are going to experience it, whether you know it or you don't know it. Who cares? Okay? My moon is in Leo. And I'm a Taurus. And the moon is in Taurus. So, you know. So, of course, I'm going to talk about business, being a second house. I'm going to talk a little bit about stability. I'm going to remind you on how to craft these things for yourself, not just for them. Now, so they take that holiday, for example, the one that is coming, the 8-8. For example, nyinyi sasa, during that thing, you'll be protesting. Munasema you'll be on the streets.
No.
Okay?
No.
Are we back? Let me see. Yes, we are back. So, for example, during that day, you'll be in the streets. You'll be protesting. Okay? But I want you to observe a pattern. Nataka ukae chini uchukue kalamu. I want you to take a pen. Because I was waiting for you guys to see it, you don't see it. I want you to take a pen. I want you to write down the days that they have been wanting you on the streets. The dates. Write the dates. amekwambia tarehe 8 mwezi wa 8 hiyo itakuwa kubwa kuliko zote. Nani alikuambia? Nani ali who chose that date because you are saying you are leaderless, the Gen Z? Who picked that date? Go back to the other Tuesdays. Who said you'll be demonstrating on Tuesdays, mass day? Who said? Who said that? Who said that? Who said that? Look at the first protest that you had. Who said that? Who is printing those things out? You see, even your present president is not aware. He's just participating in something. That is, even when he's coming to speak, he doesn't even know what to do. He doesn't even know how to react, because for him it's a surprise. He's like, wait a minute, I thought my work as a president is to keep stealing and, you know, doing my thing. And I've been doing it. It has been working so long. He has been in the government for over 10 years, past previous governments, 20 years. It has been working in the old world where all those people you have voted for have never represented you. It has just looked like they were representing you because you had a road, higher thoughts. Watch it, Peter. Air, intellect, intelligence, air sign. A plane has to pass. Thought. Now, or a stick, or the Moses staff, come on, Moses, okay? Or a flaming sword, na vitu kama hizo. Shout out to the subconscious community. So, whoever has been picking these dates for you to be on the streets, you are being played. You are being played. Whoever is picking Tuesday for you to be on the streets when it is mass day, not even that one. The other one I told you are going to be successful. I think there was a Scorpio moon. Whatever alignment, it's on my Facebook page. I put it there. I had even said the gods are behind you. But of course, that when you're going to protest, they don't even know that. Isi vitayao. This is spiritual warfare on a deep fucking level. It's so deep, like for you to see it. It's so deep. But it's not even deep. It's so simple. It's so easy to see it. And I'm gonna break it down for you. Now, when you wanajua, the people who we do, the soul group people, the subconscious community, the conscious community, na wale wote tumekuwa tukimeet physically. You know that when you are practicing the 12 disciples ritual, or what you call the 12 disciples and you being the Christ, the consciousness, or when you are going through the calendar, what you call the horoscope, or through the highs of Horus, the sun, aka in your calendars, when you start from January, and then you come all the way back to December. This is what these people are doing. So, they know that the year does not begin in January. They know that no year starts at Capricorn. They know that. They are very clear with that. These people know, remember, they come up with this. So they know that during Capricorn, what you call December, that is the 10th month. And the 10th month is your kneecaps. Nimagotienu, Capricorn, the goat.
Wewe, Coco. Sasa no, sasa sitafunza juu nataka kutoka nje nikufungulie.
You back bana, you communicate. Shinda hapo kirukaruka hapo ndani. You back. And I let you out. Na usikuje kukula hizi mushroom na okota hapa. Tusikizane hiyo tu. If I let you out, you leave my mushrooms alone. But you can go and get out. Go and coco the poop. This is Bob. Hi Bob. Show them your dick, Bob. Come on, Bob. Show them your. Good boy, Bob. That is Bob. He's Bobby. Coco has gone to drink some water. The other one is in the shamba eating avocados. You know, I have avocados everywhere. You look in my compound, there's avocados everywhere. There's avocados on the window. Siko wapi? There's avocados on the window. There must be others on the ground somewhere. It's the land of avocados, eh? Oh, you don't believe me? Nikupeleke uone avocados imejaa chini. Acha nikuonyeshe avocado imejaa chini. Tumechoka kuokota. Sasa zinaiva hapa, unakuja unakula. The dogs just come and eat. All these are avocados. All these. all these avocados. That's how we put them. Ziive zikiwa hapo. Because there's no space to put them in the house. You just shake the tree, zinakaa hapo. Now what the dogs do, they come and eat, yona, ameenda kukula. Na hawezi maliza. Siona ule anakula avocado kwa shamba ule. Unaona? Unaona kula nini huko? Avocado. Is it even an avocado kwa shamba? Shout out to the dogs of avocado. Avocado dogs. Let's get back to the live. Tukiokota hii mushroom. Hata nimesahau tulikuwa naokota hizi mushrooms, eh? So now nilikuwa nimezianika hapa. I like dried mushrooms, so because also when they are dried you can pack them for longer. Unaweza ziweka for a few more days or even a month, or you can export them. Na vitu kama hizo. Munjiro is into mushrooms now. She's cultivating mushrooms. So now back to the live. So these cats, let's call them cats. These cats, they know that the year starts in spring, or what you call the vernal equinox. However, so that they make you celebrate, this is where they get that phrase from the Bible. You make your little heaven down here. The day, the time to be happy is now. And the way to be happy is to make someone happy and to have a little heaven. So they bring their own little heaven down here with your help. You help them. Then the way they make you happy is they give you breadcrumbs. They give you these social security numbers. They give you these NSSFs. They give you these breadcrumbs where you think you own the world. However, this is how deep they are. So they know, for example, when you go outside, kama saizi hakuna jua, jua ikitoka. Saizi jua ikitokea, utaona watu inje kwa jua, watu wataenda kuota jua. When the sun comes out, birds come out to play. That is the energy of spring or birth. Sunrise, ndege wote wanapiga kelele, kila mtu anaamburuka ni 6 a.m., kila mtu ameamuka. So they look at that like an impact or a message from God. That is how they're interpreting their God. That is how they are looking at nature's, aka outside of them, and how they interpret push na uvivu tujenge taifa. Taifa ya nani? They got you everywhere. But you are building for their template, because remember, it is their calendar, it is their practices. Now, so when you are practicing Christmas around Sagittarius, pale, before to fike Capricorn, before muende New Year, Capricorn is the 10th month, your kneecaps, which is why Capricorn is the physical manifestation of the crown chakra. Ni unasemanga kiadamu ihuru ama ikomi. 10 is 1. So the 10th house and the first house, your crown chakra. That is even why you are able to design the helmet for your motorbike by looking at your knees, not a coincidence. And when you are born with your dick or your whatever in your mouth between your legs, in what you call a fetal position. So now, when they know that, they capitalize on that. Okay? So, kama ujui about the 12 disciples ritual, this is how you're supposed to live in the world. Okay? As above, so below. AKA, when you go and pray that Lord's Prayer, where you're asking your God, and may it be done in heaven as it is done down here. So when you're saying that, as it is done in heaven, as it is down here, this is what you're supposed to do. When the year starts, vernal equinox or spring, between March 26 and April 10, this year we started at April 10 because last year, 2013, was an intercalary year, a year that has 13 months. Even the women had 13 periods last year. Kama hukujua hiyo ni shida yako. But maybe you notice last year period yako ilikuwa imesonga na siku mbili. Kama una notice ingi. Ama pengine uniambia ufikiria ni kevo juu alikukura roho alifanya pengine. Ama pengine ni pH balance. Ama pengine watumianga kisabuni fulani ukafikiria ndio kilifanya period zako zichange. Hapana. Last year 2023 had 13 months. You can Google. Get on Google and look, was 2023 an intercalary year? Itakwambia yes, it had 13 months, 13 moons. AKA, it was the last sabbatical year in the Bible during the time of Joseph, where the stupid Pharaoh was dreaming and he sent for Joseph to come and interpret the dream. It was not Joseph that went. They didn't call Joseph, kuja, akakuja. No, these are virtues and principles. So it's when you understand what it means to have seven great cows eating seven, being eaten by seven whatever cows. And your man mvua ilikuwa mingi 2024. Because now in the 7 years of abundance, that is where they are getting ready for Vision 2030. Sifikiria tu, na wanakuambia, building back better. Unafikiria tu ni politics. No, they know everything. We just left the 7 bad years. Ukitaka kuhesabu, start sasa. Hapo nimekuambia 2024. Go back from 2023. Go back 7 years. Uone kwenye Uhuru alikosania na Ruto. Those were the 7 bad years. From hapo, enda another back years back. Utaona kwenye walishikana na Ruto walikuwa na inuona mkono. Na ile miaka mbaya ilifanya Kibaki atoke. Go back 7 years. Utaona ile miaka ilikuwa mzuri ya Kibaki. Na pali maneno ya Moi ilikuwa noma. You go back 7 years. Start from 2024, go back each and 7 years. The last 7 years were the years in the Bible where we had the emaciated cows eating the fat ones. Those other years before that 7 years will be the good years. Then the other 7 years, the yenye mnashindamu kisema iko kwa Bible. So right now, Vision 2030, we are in the 7 good years that are coming. Vision 2030. But they are not going to be good for you because they have planned something for you the moment they even started putting this in your system to take away your memory, to make you forget about anything. Hakuna mtu anakumbuka kitu siku hizi. Everybody is forgetful. Expect me, I didn't get that shit or anyone near my family. Na siku nunua, my name is not even in the system. Hata huduma namba sijaipata. Yet, nahudumiwa kama wewe, maybe even better than you. So now, I don't need to go through the 12 disciples ritual. I'm assuming anyone who's watching ashai kuwa kwa live yangu, so they, you know how to practice it. Right now, the sun is in Leo, or the tribe of Judah, aka jua ndio imeingia mwezi wa tano. Kama hivyo ndio nataka kuseme. Wewe kama uko July, August, ni sawa sawa, hiyo ni calendar, hata sisi tunaitumia calendar. But the sun just moved into the fifth house. So, the fifth house, hiyo mnaita Orion's Gate, which is your solar plexus, or your Jesus, or your Phoenix, or your Christ consciousness, wewe mwenyewe, your mini sun. When you're supposed to be taking all that energy for you to create or get what you call a firmware update. Wenye simu yako inaweza update, ukute ilikuwa Android 4, saizi ni Android 50. How they do it, jua na jua. So for them, they do rituals, but they take all the energy. They give you fear. Fear is the greatest for you. So right now, instead of the whole world being focused on the Lion's Gate and going through the firmwares and into new consciousness, you are fearful of the four horsemen. Ati sasa jua litengeneza kafarasi hapo na wanajua mnazomanga Bible, wakajua mtashina mukikuta. And there was a horseman riding on the water and oh my God, it is so satanic. Did you see the things they were doing? Da, those are only visible and can only get a reaction from the low-hanging fruit. Other spirits are busy doing the same rituals for themselves. If you want to know what ritual you're supposed to be doing, all you have to do is go into your Bible. We started in Yahweh. This went into Baal, Canaan, the second house, Taurus, around May 15 to whatever. Then we moved into Sodom and Gomorrah, which is the Gemini, the twins. Then we went into the sun in Cancer, which is Beru, the Jerusalem, the heart area. Now the sun is in the fifth house, the Lion of Judah, the tribe of Judah, whatever. Sasa, end usome your story. Then you are going to know what to do and what not to do. Niyo tu. Don't have to complicate life. Niyo tu. Just go to the Bible now, understand you are in that land. Then, ukishajua what to do from the Bible, sasa ngojea hiyo siku, ama start doing your rituals. Start preparing yourself for that. Si munasumanga, munasumanga Bible. You are very good with the Bible. Sindio, you are Christian. Sindio, eh. When was the Passover? Jumi nilio, nilingojea niona wa Christiano, enye naonanga huku majirani wa kikura, unleavened bread, siku ona. Me, I had unleavened bread. I roasted the bread. Me, myself. Nichukua unga, bila yeast, nikapika mkate, bila mafuta. And I took it to that tree. That is where I do my rituals, outside. Iyo tree, itawa muharago, and I took my chapati there and wine. So,
Wewe ukisema oh the Passover una Google tu unge Google one. Oh my god, I'm supposed to be eating unleavened bread. I can't wait for the bread to rise. Unleavened bread and some wine. Of course you know I brew my own wine, so I had my hibiscus wine and bread and I gave it to the gods. Or the demons or whatever you want to call it, it doesn't matter. Unajua sasa ukifika hapo unafanya vitu mashaitani ni sawa. Enda ufanyue a Catholic, enda upee pastor, ainue mkate akunywe, wewe utakunywa. Fadhali mimi nilionja wine yangu na nikawapea. Na mkate. Wewe ile unapeangwa once in a while when they feel like it. Leo ni nini? It's Lent. It's black ash. Can I give them bread or we give them every Sunday? So it loses its significance. So every Sunday they take you through their own mini Ramadan, their own mini Passover. But it's a Passover to a new week. So every Sunday you have your own Passover. Every Sunday Catholic Church you had your mini Passover, but you are missing the macro. You are missing the point, so you are sinning. Now, so this is how they do it. So they take a holiday like Capricorn, the new year. So they know it's the 10th house. So you know it's about foundating things down, the money, the CEO, all that energy. So for you, during that Capricorn season, they make you go through the new year. They make you celebrate New Year's. But their New Year is the heaven they brought down here. After their New Year, you have to pay new license fees during Capricorn. Ujue mwaka ijaisha, wanajua. Si ati wajua, wanajua. But it is their New Year. They are bringing their heaven down here as a practice. Unanunua a new license for your business. Unajua ni January, renew your fees, renew your licenses, renew your driving license, renew your shop license, renew your fire extinguisher. Go to the county government, we are renewing everything. It's a new year, but it's not for you. It's not for you. Remember, we are not in that time of renewal. We are not in Aries. We have not even close to the new year, bath, spring, burayakehu. We are not even there. But they have brought their heaven down here. They have made you participate in renewing things. Remember, your subconscious doesn't know what whether you are joking or it's true. So your subconscious knows it's a new year. So your subconscious will not even allow you to practice a new year during spring because you are already living in reverse, out of a chaos. So that is one win for them. So when you are supposed to be wewe mwenyewe, when you're supposed to be doing it for yourself, inakupita. So right now, you are paying attention to the Olympics, their light. They have lit their light, their torch. They have lit their Orion. So nyinyi wote, oh, the opening ceremony of the Olympics, oh my God, he's going to light the light. Oh my God. So as you are paying attention to that, they make you fearful. Oh my God, is that a Perman horse? Oh my God, this is so demonic. Oh my shit. Remember, they tell you, and remember what is sports. One of their pillars. We have business, entertainment, education, politics, and religion. So that is one of theirs, the sports. Niao, si yako, that is one of their pillars. They created the sports. Before they came, wewe huku unajua maneno ya marathon, ulikuwa unakimbia wapi kwa mlima, ukienda wapi, you had everything. They came up, they created marathon. Oh, Kenya, you are the greatest marathon. Of course, they made you run. Masa would make you run. Wewe, come. Give him a letter. Send him to the other port station in Utawara. Send him now. So some Kikuyus would go see some water, sit on the side of the road, drink some water. He would run, get to Rangata, start seeing animals, start looking at the animals with his letter. You know, Kikuyu is looking at the buffalo. See hanango, bae. So they realized, oh my God, the car engines can run. We can create a sport. What do we call it? A marathon. Call it a marathon. And take that. They showed us, take that, stamp it, give it a name, call it a marathon. Say it was discovered by, come up with a name. Who wants that? We can take it. Call it a marathon. Come on, you don't have to win. Just give whoever, give one brother a medal. Create something. Yeah, template that. Copyright that, that's a business forever. Okay, yes, now that becomes ours. So that the divide and conquer, and they're doing things that you can do for yourself. That was a small example. So now, when they know, for example, the Lion's Gate, or for example, when they know about the new year, the Capricorn energy, they capitalize on that because the 10th house energy is kind of
a mini bath. It's kind of a mini renewal. It has that 10th house energy, which is foundating things or money. So they take advantage of that, and then now you add your energy into that. That is why during that time, your Christmas, they give you sales. Unasikia, hey, there's Christmas shopping on the 12 days of Christmas. My mother came to me. Ujuize kwanini 12? Ujuize? Ujuize kwanini 12? You're not asking yourself, why is it 12? 12 days of Christmas. Why? You're not asking about, what is this game they are playing with us? Kwanza ujuwa kwanza 12 ni 3. First of all, you understand that when you are talking of the 12, you're observing as the 13th. For you to observe 12, you must be the 13th. Afu nasema 13 evil. At a floor does not need to have the 13th floor. Then when you know about the 13, you know it is 4. It is a thought. It is when you, one individual, you are relating to your surroundings, but they make you think it's evil, but they use that against you. If you want to go deep, go and research the 13 witchcraft. Go and research number 13. What do you call it? The name is... Go and study the esoteric meaning behind number 13. Then you are going to understand how to use that, how they use that magic square, which is the magic square of number 4, or the 4 magic square. We have, they like using the 7... The seven square for the Saturn. That is why they are so hard on Saturday. You go and rest on Saturday, it's a weekend and all that drama. The Saturn planet, the rings around the Saturn planet, which is what you call the Nike sign, the tick, that Nike sign that they have given to Ineos. Okay, everything is witchcraft, even these three lines. Okay, this is witchcraft. Okay, this is good witchcraft because it makes them millions and billions of dollars. If you know what three lines mean esoterically, every time you see a three lines, it communicates to your psyche. Well, where is it, Jua? But it's communicating to your subconscious. See, it is beautiful. There's nothing beautiful about three lines. Mental witchcraft. So now that is how they come up with the logo. Sasa unashindo kiita kiatu yako majina. Iwezi ya muka, iyo kiatu yako wezi ya muka. Unless the people give it energy subliminal without knowing why they are attracted to Nike. That Saturn ring, the ring that is supposed to be around that planet you call Saturn. Those rings, iyo ring, do you nakuanga Nike? That is what makes you might buy Nike. Yata kai metengenezo China. Siya tunanunua tijuni Nike. Okay? The spirit cares about symbols, signs. That is why you pay attention to the cross. It doesn't mean shit. Signs, symbols, sigils, those things, all those things that have that as that wave. Okay, your spirit loves that symbology.
Okay,
signs and symbols rule the world. Now, so what they do. So I want to show you how you can do it for yourself now. Wale wanyo walikuwa na kuja soul group. Remember we talked about making your own holiday and we made our own holidays in your calendar. Now I want to show you how you can do it with your family and create your own holiday down here. For example, when, let's say for example, this Orion. So let's say your grandfather, Babu Yenyu, there's no need of munaimbanga ati George Washington, sijui Jomo Kenyatta, ati alikuwa mababu yenyu, mababu yenyu wakiwa na nani. Wewe uko na hiyo pesa. Wewe unalinga na Jomo Kenyatta, uko na shamba wewe na yeye ni skuta. Ati Kenyatta wito, wenyu na nani? Kenyatta ni wao na wanyo waliachua mashamba. Unaona hizo masaimara. Unaona hizo mashamba zinatoshana na province. Hao ndio wanaweza sema mzee, wao. Huo ndio baba, huo ndio babu yao. Mzee Jomo Kenyatta ni babu yao. Si babu yangu mimi sina shamba. I don't even have an acre in my name. So wacha kuniambia ati tumetenga. Hiyo nonsense. You're making us think we are together. We are not together. Na tumetenga. Mukiwa na nani? Mimi nikiangalia sina gari ya government. I don't have a government. Unless uanze kunilipa ndio utakuwa unasema tumetenga. When you start paying me, Ruto, when you start paying me, unaweza niambia tumetenga, tumefanya. At this particular moment, I look like I'm the one who's paying the government. So mumetenga na nani? So now... So you pick a day like during that alignment that is coming, the Lion's Gate. Then let's say your grandfather was a grandfather muneza ringa, babu yenyu alikuwa anawapenda, kwa babu yenyu ulikuwa unaenda unakuta nyama all the time, kwa babu yenyu ulikuwa unaenda nawachinjia mbuzi, kwa babu yenyu ulikuwa unaenda unakunywa soda, hata uko unataka kutoka kwa babu yenyu rudi kwa mama yenyu. Sasa huyo ni babu, acha mababu wengine, hata uwezi enda kwao. Your fathers, your wounded fathers, akina Devendi and all those people in rural ships, au akina Sudi wanaongea kama watoto, ndio watoto wenyu kumaana zako. Nasema watoto wenyu na nani? So now, what they do, you take that grandfather, mwenye alikuwa anasaidia kwenyu, mwenye unajua huku kaa alikuwa anatambuli, huku kaa mamangu alienda akapata mimba, huku kaa akamkaribisha. Mimi nilielewa na guka yangu, na akasema hata ile shamba nilipewa na guka yangu, na mimi nilikuja na mamangu. Now that's a guka worth calling an ancestor. Huyu amepita, huyu mwenye guka yako unasemanga ni guka yako, na hakukuachia hata switi, hata kiatu moja hakukuachia, guka yako hakukuachia hata tairi ya kucheza nayo, even a tire like this one. Guka yako hakukuachia hata tairi kama hii uchezange nayo, hii uzungushange usemange hii niliachiwa na guka hii. He didn't even leave you a tire like this. Hapo unashinda ukisema hapa ati ancestor. Ancestor mgani huyo? Weak ancestor. An ancestor who didn't know how to build. So now, you take that guka, mwenye unajua sasa this guka is a good one. You call a family meeting before your siku unachagua, unasema 8:8 tutakuwa wapi, ama hiyo weekend inakuja, unasema nimetoa mbuzi na hii mbuzi nataka wala watu wote tunakumbuka guka, tukutane huko tukumbuke matendo mema ya guka. Shit, remember this is a brand, this is a name. Guka ni jina, guka si ule guka. Guka ni matendo yake, venye guka alifanya mema. Alikuwa guka kushikanisha watu, ukipata mimba na huko anakukaribisha nyumbani akufukuzi. Most of you are married because you could not afford to go to your father and tell your father, dad, I'm pregnant. That shame was too much because your dad was not healed. Your dad is emotional immature, so you had to go and settle with your boyfriend even when you are not ready. Most of you, that is how you came into this world. Planned marriages, unplanned marriages. That is how I started. My mother, you see, my mother was fucking with my father, and my mother was young, she was 17, and my dad made her pregnant. So of course by default she had to leave her, na alikuwa amekuja kazi, you know, my dad fucked my mother, and my mother alikuwa amekuja kazini kwao kwa buchari yao. So already the starting point was wrong. Hakuna love hapo. Najua, maybe my dad did even have like emotional intelligence. Otherwise, his father would have taught him to fuck up the ladder or something. I'm not saying that my mother is down the ladder. We manifest ourselves down. I'm just talking, point view. This is how you heal your trauma and curses. So that is how the relationship started. And of course, you know how a relationship starts? It's how it ends. So it's been 15 years now separated. Kila mtu akona na huko. Unhealed parents from the unhealed grandfathers to us now who are healing. And the healing generation that we are birthing. So now, you take that grandfather and you create a holiday around him. So the holiday becomes all the good things. So on that day, you only speak about what good your grandfather did. Remember, your grandfather name lives within you. Muko na tuguka, muko na tutoto, tunaitwa kama yeye. So all the good quality energies that as you are going through the lion's gate portal, all that energy you are sending to the name that was guka, these children. That is how you speak blessings onto your children. Si kwenda kuwapatia tu wanamwagiriwa kanyari, ameweka nini? Africans, you are so demonic. Kanyari ameweka kipembe, ati anamwagia wa mama kichwa. Ule mwingine na yeye, sijui ule kumbavu mwingine na yeye anaosha watu mguu. It's something is wrong with you. No, something is wrong with you. If in 2024, Kanyari ametoka kupiga watu finger, hiyo mkono amepigana nao finger, unakuja unakaa chini na akona na kipembe na ati anakupea mafuta upako, the same kitu. You like suffering, Africans. You love it. You love it. Ule mwingine ati anaosha mguu, ati kuja hapa aoshe mguu. Something is wrong. It's 2024. We're in a new world. Kanisa ilikuwa imefungwa 2 years wakati wa COVID. Kufungwa. Nyumba imefungwa. Venye unaweza funga choo isitumiwe na watu. Choo ufungwa. Nasikia wewe, ni nini? Nataka mnisaidie na ufungo ya choo. Tamoe service yosia kioro. Hebu matiga madho ukia kioro huko. Choo inafungwa, kanisa inafungwa. hapo nasema ati ni nyumba ya Mungu. Think. Ati huko kuna kitu kilikuwa kinapita huko kwa hewa. Kwani mulidunga hewa sindano? Ama muliponya hewa aje? Muliponya aje hewa? Hiyo kitu mlikuwa unasema iko kwa hewa, ilikuwa kwa hewa. Ilikuwa kwa hewa. Mliwekwa vitu kwa mwili. Nani alidunga kwa hewa? Hewa iliwekwa nini? Ilipuliziwa nini ndio ipone? Unaweza jiponya kitu iko nje na kuweka kitu ndani? Of course wajinga watasema ati ni ku prevent. Sisi hatujai prevent. Ilienda wapi? Mbona sijai kutana nayo hata waleo? Iko wapi? Even today I've never met it with my whole family. Hatujai kutana nayo. And all the friends who never got that. Mbona hatujai kutana? Ilienda wapi? Kwani ilienda wapi? Enye nyinyi mko sawa, mko safe, mliwekwa, si ndio mliwekwa kinga ni sawa. Ni mliwekwa kinga ni sawa. We have no fight with that. Everything has a reason. However, mbona wenye wa kukingwa hiyo tatuionangi? Kwani ilienda wapi? Where is it? So now, you take that holiday, your father's day, and mkitaka kuchinja mnaweza chinja ama mkose. Mnaweza kula mayai, pengine hata hamna kitu ya kuchinja, whatever you have. But you make sure that on that day, the only thing or the only person who's winning ni what your grandfather was winning. Bringing people together. That becomes your Olympic. Sasa, they bring their little heaven down here with the Olympics. You give them all their energy. Hey, they are competing. Oh, and they are still making you fight against each other. Russia versus Kenya. Kenya versus Japan. Japan versus Egypt. You may look at it like it's sport. Hakuna sport hapo. Do you know ile blood, sweat and tears that goes into preparing to go and compete? That's like war. But instead of going to war, now we send one person. Can you send us your best wrestler? Come here. Come here, Tiny Goliath. Come here. David, what's your name? David, come here, David Omanyara. Kuja hapa, David. We want you to go and face a Goliath there. What Goliath? A Goliath of Gorogotha. He's a Russian. You go and run against him. Sawa, David Omanyara? Yes, you go and represent us. So it is still the same arena games. But you fail to understand the reason they choose these dates to have the Olympics, where the sun will be, the tribe of Judah, the sun as it at your solar plexus.
Kwa umekuja hapa kuokota nini? Mushroom. Sasa hata tulianza kuongea tukasahau. Kaini hapo kwa mushroom kwanza ni adjust. Mushroom zilikuwa zimeandikwa hapa. My cat can decide. You are not going to mwezi anika mushroom kwenye napitanga. Fuck all of you. Ikagonga uteo. So ndio tunaokota mushroom. This is mushroom out for drying. I like my mushrooms dry. But I like my women wet. I'm talking about mushrooms. Mushrooms, I like them dry. Sometimes wet. But I like them when they are dry. Dried mushrooms, you can store them longer. Of course, I like my women wet. A little bit of emotions. That is what I mean by wet. You know. A little bit of emotion. Unajua? Asemanga slippery when wet. Na vitu kama hizo. So
the crafting, these are how they give them names. Let's say we are in government, we are in rulership. When you are mechagulio your date 8-8, nawambia munachezwa sana. You are being played a lot. A lot. Na si nyinyi, ata you are president. You don't even know how these things are played. I'm going to bring you awareness to what is happening. So let's say, even all those things walikuwa wametenga ati saba saba. Unafikiri ati ni Raila alisema saba saba. Of course Raila alikuwa anafandiwa. So mwenye walikuwa na wafund hiyo wakati wa democracy, ndio waliambia, can you choose July 7, the great June line? Can you choose July 7? Muite saba saba and go for a mega riot. Sasa nyinyi mmechagua 8-8. On year 8. Are you thinking? Am I the only one who's thinking? You are in the year of the dragon, year 8. Unakumbuka kulikuwa na saba saba. Now you want to create an 888. 888. On year 8. Hey. You are being played, bana. You are being played. Unless you know what you are doing. You know you are giving us a lot of work. All these other days that you are on the streets. You are forcing me to be on the streets. To come and do witchcraft on behalf of you. Huh? You are giving spiritual people a lot of work when you're on the streets, when you choose the dates that are not. Wako hapo wakipepea watoto wakuwe safe. Because you also have children out there. We have children out there. We have thoughts and feelings out there that are manifested. I don't have to be the father. I know my thought and feeling is out there. As a descended thought and feeling. That's why they say protect the children. Let me show you how they do it. So, they pick a date, for example, the way I showed you, how you pick a Capricorn season to do Christmas. Let me bring you up to date mpaka hapo. Mwaka inaanzanga March, between March 26 and April 10, depending on the year. AKA, the beginning of the year, or spring, or equinox, or the beginning of the heavy rains. Zenye ziliwaosha hapa. So, that is the only time utaona vitu jaiona ziki spring. Mpaka unaita mamako, Mom! Hii ni mumea gani sijaiona? Mamako anakuambia, ai, hata mimi nimekaa miaka mingi sijaiona, lakini ya Mungu ni mengi. Mungu anapanda. Everything is springing. 30 days after, we move into Taurus, the second month, or Baal, anchoring down throat chakra. So, hiyo time when you're supposed to be speaking or kulimia, ndio nanyi mnalimia shamba. Tunaenda na mwezi, muko kwa shamba mukilimia. Then another 30 days, that sun moves into Gemini, the third sign. Mutable communication, air, communication. Kwa shamba, mimea inatoa maua, ina communicate. This is what I'm going to produce. Kero. Iyo kero, kuna mbosho isha atoka, unaweza kula. So tunapiga kelele sana. Dokedu yeto vosa na tomiji. Najua kwako imemea, mboga zimetoke. It has been 3 months kutoka kunyeshe. Ukienda kwa shamba, unaweza toka na viazi. Kero. Kero na Kikuyu ne kero. It is telling you, kero. Ate mumera ni urakuera, it is telling you. In a flowering, it's flowering. It's sending you flowers. Send me my flowers. Thank you, Amudaka. I'm sending you flowers. They are flowering. I'm sending you flowers because soon you are going to expect this amount of maize. Kero. Then the sun moves into Cancer or the fourth house. Or in the Bible, during Noah's floods. Or high noon. For the people in Kemet, Egypt, Nunetango Anu. Then, during that time, Cancer season, it's a time of caring, home. Sayo hata wanyo walikuwa na alimi uwezi pata hata mtu wakusaidia kulimia. Kila mtu, kwangu hata ndio kunoma. So everybody is back home. Unatafutanga mtu wakupea kazi kwa shamba uwezi ona. Ai, kila mtu wakokoa wakona chakula, wanaeza ringa. Mpaka mfanyi kazi wako limuambia naeza panda sukuma pale. Saizi ya mepanda yake. Hata naeza kuambia. Unajua nimecherewa nikirimia yangu. The sun moves into the fifth house where we are now when they are doing the Olympics. Tribe of Judah, whatever happened during that time. Then the sun is going to move into Maria Immaculate or Virgo. Okay? Or the moon. Let's talk about the moon. The sun inakuanga imefuata mwezi. Inakujanga baadaye. Virgin Mary, Maria Immaculate, that Virgo energy, your ability to bend over backwards, aka negotiate or step your foot forward. Then the sun is going to move into Libra, the seventh month. Watu wa Kemet, watasema ni maat. Shout out to maat, equal day, equal night. So watachora kamtu kakona wings, ameangalia huku, sijua ameangalia wapi. Wings, equal wings, representing day and night ni equal. 12 day, 12 hours day, 12 hours night. Zimetoshana, the day na night. So it's about justice. Around that time, watu uchapo, utaona tuvita tumetokea. Kuna watu wa milisha itatokea. It's about justice. They practice this as an example. So that is the time pengine wameplan, ceasefire, ya mavado. Unajua, they have to wait for that. Unajua wao kufuata rituals. So watasema hapo finally, we have decided to pull off, but for now, let's keep the fireworks going. Mavado versus Vibes Cartel. Wenye wanajua naongea maneno gani wanajua. Atuongei maneno ya Mavado hapa. Gaza, Vibes Cartel, Mavado. Umejua ni nani saa tunaongelea tukiguza Gaza. Unajua wengine? Wanasemanga they are the children of God. When you run the world. Ni familia. It's a family, eh? Every nation, or what you call a state, nasemanga Kenya state, is a state of that location. Every nation is a business to them. Kenya is a business. Kenya is our business. Mukiwa na nani wewe? Kenya is your business, mukiwa na nani? Your first president was in bed with a white woman when his brothers were in the forest. Let that sink in. In the 50s, he was in bed with a white woman, wakapata mtoto na white woman. Wengine wako kwa kichaka. Not raping a white woman. Ah, pana. Kwao, kwao, kwao. As a guest, na bepewa msichana white, lara na huyo, na utupe mbegu, eh? Atakutafutia huko, huko. Mnaita, mnataka gani huko kwanyu? Margaret, tukutafutia msichana huko. Wewe kula hii kwanza, hii ni yako. Afu wende huko jifanye wao. Sawa? Eh, na uongee kizungu mzuri sana. Na siku hizi unachoma picha sana. Unyato kuja hapa. Unajua nimekuona mpaka unapigwa picha na Mason Ring. Hawezi jua ring ni ya nini. Ah, okay, sawa, enda. Na hiyo leather jacket. Na uandike kitabu, eh? Uite aje. Ite, si wanapenda hawa Kikuyu wanapenda Mount Kenya. Ite hiyo kitabu Facing Mount Kenya. Ah, watafurahi. Eh, kongethera Kirinya. Ah, you cannot convince them you are not theirs. Eh, go and do that. Go and do that. We'll give you half the country. Don't worry. We'll give you half the country. Yeah, we'll give you half the country. You know, we know your skin color is not the same as that, but your blood. Yeah, your blood. We'll even make sure utazikwa kama queen, wewe. Mwili yako haitaiguza mchanga. Mwili yako haitaiguza mchanga. Mpaka ile mama aende, queen aende, utaiguza mchanga. Eh, wewe ni wa mama, wewe ni wa madhe. Eh. Ai, siliona madhe alikufa akawekwa kwa vault. Asi umeshindanga pale mausoleum. Uwezi guza mchanga. Si ndakwambia wewe ni wetu. Utaguza mchanga aje. Enda.
I was waiting for the trash to take itself out, eh? Ajua, when I'm speaking, I can always tell when I have fake viewers. Najuanga wale wamepita tu. So I have to talk like that for them to go. Then we can jump back into our esoteric talk. Tunajua kisikia hiyo, hizi sikiza hiyo. Atiana, usiwadhi kugate Kenya hata timodo moiro. Asa hiyo, wacha waende. Oh, those are babies. Now let's back to the live. So now, when the sun is in Libra, mwezi wa saba, for the sun or the moon, then the moon moves into Scorpio. Okay? The eighth house. Which is about your desires na vitu kama hizo. Hapo ndio unapewa Black Friday, buy one TV, get 3 TV for free, buy one radio, get a whole tank of water plus spoons free. So ukienda supermarket, kila kitu inakuanga imeattachiwa price. Because at that particular moment, you are very separate. As a collective conscious, you are stuck on your own desires and feelings. So because the government does not want you to forget about business, they create a Black Friday. So everybody is, they are even waiting, they sleep outside waiting for the shops to be open, to buy their 70 TV, they wait for Black Friday. Then they go and scream, this is my TV, it's crazy, it's stupid, because the moon is in Scorpio. AKA, the moon is in your dick and pussy area, your eighth house. So it's very fixated on its desires, in it to a Black Friday. Wao unafikiria tu ni duka ni Black Friday, ni holiday. So they create a holiday around everything. But they get to keep all the money. It is their Black Friday. It is their Kirimall. Ama wataka kuniambia Kirimall ni yenyu. Wajiko. Kirimall ni yenyu. Si uniambia kama Kirimall ni yenyu. Ni yenyu. Sio yenyu. Na Amazon, Amazon. Amazon ni yenyu. Amazon. Sio yenyu, sindio? Sio yenyu, eh? Sana si ukubali bas. Ukubali. Ukubali. Nikuwa kwa shamba. Stop looking at me like that. Natoa mishege. Nikuwa kwa shamba. Nikuwa mishege. Let's get back to the teachings. Then the sun goes into Sagittarius. The moon goes into Sagittarius. When the moon is in Sagittarius, the ninth house, it's about traveling. So your time, munapewa Christmas. Hey, guy, aki basi nalipisha 2,000. Wapi? Stage yote. Unataka kuniambia nikipanda basi hapa na shukia Limuru ni 2,000. Stage yote ni 2,000. Mbaka Westa ni 2,000. Kama una 2,000, wezi enda. So, since they know it's about traveling, being home, they create a calendar around that. They call it Christmas, go see your parents, the birth of whatever, care about family, kanagage siyaro nonsense. So everybody is home. Tuadiku wana shosho. Global witchcraft again. They created the calendar like that. Okay? You're not supposed to be anywhere near Christmas with your people. You're supposed to be celebrating that time with your own family. And it should not be that crazy.
Then when the sun moves into the 10th house, Capricorn, new year, for them, they make you go into new year and start paying the licenses. Because for them now, they bring their heaven down here, their new year, before tufike ile, wakuwa mekachukua. So the sun again goes into Aquarius. That is when sasa nyinyi new year munabadilisha class, you go to a new class. Ulikuwa form 3 unaenda form 4, ulikuwa form 4 unaenda form 5, which is how you're supposed to do the 12 disciples the 12 disciples witchcraft or the 12 disciples sun practice. But now you are practicing for them, so they get to capitalize form 1, chukua school fees, si ni shule zao. A university ya chukura school fees ni shule zao, si zenyu, hizi shule si zenyu. Kama ni zenyu, curriculum ingekuanga yenyu. Curriculum yenyu ni wale wanatumanga. Teach them CBC there in Africa. Make sure you continue rooting and taking their... Sasa tunachukua miti, carbon credit. Eh. Keep taking. You took the land, now take the trees. Take the remaining land if you can. Make them pay for it every year. Give it a tax. No, charge their cuts. Yeah, every cut 200 shillings now. Pass it in the row. No, this, what do you mean? What minister? Print some money. Web, Karaja, bring 200 billion here, Kenya shillings. No, bring it in dollars. Bring it here. Give that stupid president. He likes money. Yeah, he was a chicken seller. Give him 50 billion. Put it in. Don't even tell him. Just put it in his account and inform him. Call him. Tell him you have bought him lunch, 50 billion. Eh? He has a few dogs. Give these puppets a few money. The small ones, give them coins. Give them each 2 million. And they are going to pass that thing for us. We are going to charge the cat, the dog. Then they are going to get used to that. Then what will you do? You wait 3 years. We are going to charge a cow 50,000 a year. Each cow. Yes, we can do it. They are already paying for the cat. What do you mean? They are going to resist. We are going to make them vote. They are us. We are going to amend it. What will happen? Look for another president. Give that one 50 billion. Okay, give each and his family. Where is the money going to come from? Just print it. No, don't even print it. Get on the computer. Put it. It's numbers. Put zeros. Add zeros in his account. We own the money. Who owns the money? The people. A bank, for example, if you come to Kenya, these banks, you own them. It is your money. You take to the bank, you are given a promissory note. You bring 10,000, you give the bank gives you a promissory note, promising you that they can give you. They can give you. They are not going to give you. They can give you, if things are working okay, we can give you back your 10,000. So they give you a receipt saying you have deposited. It's a promissory note because I just got paid last year. Pesa tulikuwa tumeweka Uber Bank. Uber Bank ilikuwa asi Umba. Umba is the new bank. Daraja Microfinance iko Dagureti corner. We lost our money in Daraja Microfinance. Tumelipwa juzi na Uber Bank for years. Ungetoa hata shilingi. Ulipewa promissory note. So you give the bank money, they give you a promissory note. 1,000 people bring their money, you are given 1,000 promissory notes. However, 100 people are going to come for a loan. So we give them your money to go on a loan. And every day you come, we give you a promissory note that we have your 2 million. But we don't have it. We have given this person to go and develop the world. You get it? Akina World Bank, wanna pay a country to develop the countries, to develop their towns, to develop their businesses. Kenya is a business. It's only town. They look at them like towns. Okay? Now, those banks that you are giving the money, our to your stakeholders, sasa kuna wenye wamechukua hiyo pesa yote, they own the money. A few families, they own the money. Ndio wanakopeshanga hata World Bank. One World Bank, see, it's still a bank. Even World Bank operates on promissory. Ni unasikianga World Bank. Wanaweza print pesa anyway. So unafaa ujiulize, whom do you? Ati America was... Wait! Trillions. It owes to who? Who? The people who came up with that bargaining system. It's called a bargaining system. It's not money. A bargaining system. The people who own the witchcraft to create a bargaining system run the world. So, the same way I told you for your grandfather, that is how now they do. So they pick a date, a Galileo. Listen, Sasa. They pick a Galileo, the Met Gala. Jimu naitanga Met Gala. Unaendanga Met Gala fashion. Hey, we are here for the Met Gala fashion. They make you dress extraordinary and shine. But as above, so below, it is the Galileo energy. Enda ugogu. Gugu, Galileo, holiday, Galileo energy, Galileo esoteric, Galileo astrology. Utastuka. Aya, kumbe hata kuna kuonga na siku kama ina, dasijai jua. Eh, wanaitanga Met Gala. So nyimu unaendanga fashion. Oh my God, did you see Megan Thee Stallion? What happened to Megan Thee Stallion? You know, she bought another ass, another silicone, 10 times bigger. Oh my God, I didn't see that. Who is that? Without a waist. Ah, that is the old woman. Which one? Ah, the one that was made a sex tape with Ray J. Oh, that is a Kim Kardashian. Of course, the one. You remember, their father is confused. He doesn't know whether he's a man or a woman. That is one of their families. We distract them. Why is she not breathing? Ah, for the cameras. Make her dress very tight. She's old and she has to maintain some relevancy. You know what we did? What? We played with the numbers and she found herself, she's no longer as popular. Even with the show. Nah, she's just a puppet. So, the Met Gala, where they make all these people dress crazy, that is something you're supposed to do with your wife, whoever, am I your spouse, am I your girlfriend. On that day of the Met Gala, you're supposed to call your wife or girlfriend or mother figure, or female figure, or whatever you can dress with. Umvalishe, yani akitoka inje, kila mtu anaona, shit, you are dressed. Now, as a man who's doing the ritual, you walk with your woman in the streets. All eyes are on her. But when all eyes are on her, you are carrying your magic wand. Wewe, you are carrying your magic wand. You are carrying your Harry Potter stick. Umeyonanga kwa Harry Potter. You are carrying your Harry Potter stick. The stick ana pointing milango hivyo anafungua nayo. Harry Potter. You have your Harry Potter. You have your stick. For the Kikuyus, kuna kakiti kakijiti wanapeango hivi. Kakijiti. Wanapeango hivi. Kule kwa mehirika kenda. Anaekangu wa chuma, na kanapaku wa green. Lakini wajui ni nini yo. It's a magic wand. Okay? Huh? Nika magic wand ka nini? Nika wand. Wand, a magic wand. Nika Harry Potter stick mahe yako. No imati yako kiri raki u. No kune yomane yako kero e. Uwewe getu gati. Etu wakune gela gaka. Uwe da kume nyane gaka kiuka kweja gawamu. I can teach you how to use it. Now, so during the Met Gala, of course the magic stick is not carried every day. It's carried only when you have a specific goal that you want to attain and you need to harvest power, energy from the sky, kama Harry Potter, unafaa unachukua huku juu, iyo nguvu yote, unachukua iyo nguvu yote, to go and use. Shout out to Melek, kuna mahali tulienda na the great Kanso, and he had his magic wand with him. Na nilimuona vizuri sana akiwa kazi, I saw him. Shout out to that great alchemist. Now, he may think I didn't see him, you know, sometimes ego can deflect someone. He may think I didn't see him. I saw him working very busy. Ptah! He was working very hard with his stick. Shout out to him. I shout out all spirits. Now, because when you're a bigger spirit and when you see someone doing whatever spiritual practice, if you know they know something, you shout them out. You don't destroy them. Okay? But then again, some spirits be so demonic. Anyway, back to the live. So, on that day, you take your magic, your wand, unakuanga umecharge, inakuanga na crystals, okay, inakuanga na crystals. Now you know the relevance of the crystals. That is why Jomo Kenyatta, magic wand yake, geshuthe ya Jomo Kenyatta, ilikuanga na stones. Kenyatta, ile geshuthe Kenyatta ilikuanga nayo, iyo geshuthe, harambe, ilikuwa na stones, ilikuwa imewekwa stones, kama ungeiangalia, ungeona iko na stones. Lakini unajua sawa ulikuwa tu unaona geshuthe. Ulikuwa tu unaona geshuthe. Harambe! Nyayo! But it was a magic wand. It was a magic wand. Moi na ya likuja na njogoma. So they evolved. Wakatoka huko the masons. That became too obvious. So walijibadilisha. Sikuizi si lazima abebe hivyo. Kuna vitu zingine wanabeba. So moi na ya yake likuanga ni rungu ya ivory. Ilikuwa imetoka kwa ivory. Ilikuwa magic wand yake. Walikuwa sha kuwa mason. Alikuwa amefunzwa. Watu wamefunzwa, but it is still weak magic. The Masons have weak magic. Their magic only works because they use fear tactics. Mtu anakuja kuatisha. Tunajua nilikuwa na nguvu ya kuzima internet na si kuzima.
unajua Sri Lanka, mimi hata si mbaya, nilikuwa na nguvu ya kustima stima na internet, but kwa sababu mimi si mbaya, si kuona, nikaona tu niache nyinyi. Otherwise I had all the powers and the machinery. Huu unatuambia uko na kichwa mzuri wewe, wewe huu unatisha nani? Wewe unatisha nani? Ukuzima, uwezi zima kama ujaambiwa, uwezi zima hiyo kama ujaambiwa, uwezi zima internet kama haujaambiwa uzime. Jaribu uzime leo, I dare you, zima leo, tukuogope wewe. You are a puppet, you have weak magic, uwezi zima internet, you are a nobody, you are just a pawn ya kutumika. So during the Met Gala, that stick, the magic one, unakuanga umefunga na what you call crystals, different colors representing different energies. Kama ni stones are red, that would be mass energy, blue, intellect. So kuna venye unazipanga, venye unataka, unajua. So what you're supposed to do now, do I have to teach you how to use a magic wand? Ama niachane na nyinyi sasa. Too much information. You're casting pulse to swine. Anyway, understand that is what the Met Gala means. Na that is why after Met Gala, wanaendanga kufunga macho. So kulingana nani anakuhandle. Mwenye anakuhandle. Anakufanya, unaenda unafungwa macho hivi. Unapigwa, oh my God, they're on the, they're, oh, oh. Alafu kwa gazeti hapa, munashinda Facebook. Ati, oh my God, they're Illuminati. Oh my God, they are crossing mwana. Yeah, ameambiwa, wendo upigwe picha pale. Ukona check. You got your check? Yeah, our photographer is going to direct you. Go and take a picture. Photographer anakuambia, put your left hand on your eye. Put it. Look left. Again, do it again. No, don't use that. Here, take this cup. Hold it against your eye. Look left. Take a picture. You are a puppet. You are paid peanuts. So you are participating in rituals that you don't know. Okay? Nasema, oh, na Illuminati, ne, that, no. At that particular moment, all the attention that is going to them is being ripped with the people who are the magic sticks. Magic wands zao ni kubwa, zinakuanga huko, kwa arena, unaonanga ati... wanapewa idols, unaona ati best dressed. But you forget, au unaonanga hapo, Met Gala wakipiga picha, kuna VIP. Kuna wenye wa support, kuna owners wa Adidas, kuna owners wa Nike, kuna akina Elon Musk, huo ni moja. Their families, they wako huko behind the scenes. Wewe ukienda hapa saa hizi, mlikuwa kwa nini ya jogoshi? Si mlikuwa kwa nini ya jogoshi? Sio ya jogona, si ndio? Sio nyinyi wote mlionekana, hata kama ulikuwa huko, you are nobody. You went to see jogoshi, it was entertaining, but still you are nobody. Jogona was the main theme, na wenye wa react. Na kale kamsichana kanafanya mwalimu wa math, hizo science, kaliitwa hapo mbele kakashine. Wewe ulikuwa part of the nini, but behind you, hata ukiwa huko kuna wenye walikuwa VIP. Wana wenye walikuwa VIP. Hizo events za Met Gala kuna wenye wanakuanga VIP. Au sasa ndio wanakuanga wabebeba hizo magic sticks, hizo magic wands, za kuharvest hiyo energy yote inaendelea kwa room for their own magical rituals. So they name the days, the day they want. Those are their grandfathers. Every holiday, hiyo jina is a grandfather to someone. Let me show you how fucked up it is. Ile siku Raila atatoka hii dunia, very soon, Raila Amolo Odinga, utasikia watu wakisema, Sabasaba ibadilishwe, iitwe Raila Odinga Day. Situko na nyinyi. Situko na nyinyi hapa, kwani mko wapi? Tuko na nyinyi. That is the first thing. Watu utaanza kusema, utasikia imewekwa mahali kwa karatasi. They are planning to call Sabasaba Raila Odinga Day as a commemoration of him and his other father. All of a sudden, Sabasaba iitwe Raila Odinga Day. Paying homage to that name. That energy. So every day, mutakuwa muna celebrate Raila Odinga sasa imetoka Sabasaba, so they take away the energy of how many people died. So it becomes now one person now. Mtu moja sasa ndio, munasahau ile sasa inakuwa ni Raila. But that Raila, si yeye amechagua hiyo siku, imewekwa on purpose. Now all the emotions that you enact on that day, all the reasons and meanings you attach to that day, they create what it means to be a Raila Odinga. Not him, the Raila, so they are able to buy what you call an intellectual property right. And that is even now, after that, sasa mutaona cinema, inaitwa Raila Odinga, mutaona mtu ametoa cinema. But hiyo cinema, familia Raila itasaidika, watapewa pesa kidogo, disturbance fee kutumika majina yao na watu kama wao watakuja wa interview shusho yake watoto kadhaa. You know my grandfather, when my zaitangwa documentary, when my grandfather was alive, unaiona Al Jazeera, I went to see him in Kapenguria. And I remember my father cried, all of a sudden they have created a template, watakulia forever, forever, ni yao, they own everything, they own the rights, you cannot make a movie called Raila Odinga, they have copyrighted that, they copyright his kofia, they everything is gone, it's gone. Waenda ukaoshwe miguu kwa kanisa, enda uoshwe miguu, your feet are so stinking, even Jesus cannot wash them, you cannot even wash your own feet. You have to go and have a pastor wash your feet now. In 2024. Wengine mkimwagiliwa maji na kanyari, mkono imetoka kwa kinembe. Kinembe iko na herpes. Kuna kitu imebadilika, it is the same energy is updated. Wewe ndio umelala. Wewe ndio umekataa kuamuka. Wewe ndio unafikiria kuna mtu anakujali. Wewe ndio unafikiria kuna serikali inakujali. Wewe ndio unafikiria kuna dini inakujali. Wewe ndio unafikiria kuna business unajua. Hakuna kitu unajua wewe. Unafunzwa everything. You know what I'm saying? And you know, I got up and I realized that my spouse's panties imejaa hapa kwa kamba. Sasa nikageuka very fast. Nikakumbuka, when you see the size of her panties, you are going to start guessing the size of her ass. You know, you are all demonic. I know how your mind will be. Wale tukianza hiyo live tulikuwa tunakuja kuweka kuku ilalie mayai. So acha mimi niendelee na maneno ya mayai. Tuseme aliyopita sipite. Did I actually tell you the reason for this live? Wait a minute. Tulikuwa tunonokea hiyo music kelele. And we were supposed to talk about shit. Can I even remember? What was this live about? What was the live about? Oh, how they create the template. Yeah. So now, these things you can do for yourself. Okay? You can do for yourself. You can wait for the Lion's Gate portal. Do your own ritual. Okay? AKA, decide how that energy you are going to direct it yourself. It may take longer because you are doing it alone. Wale wanafanyanga teamwork. They bring all the teams from different countries. They create an arena, what you call a shrine. They play different days. They choose the day to start the games astrologically. They choose the day to close the games astrologically. They choose the game to have different games that make you move different parts of the zodiac. Your arms is your Gemini. So they choose a date to have you doing javelin. Okay, that is the day for javelin, Gemini day. But you won't know. For 2 days, you are completing trials. And then the other day, Then you move from Gemini, go to the heart, sports that make you pay attention to the heart, care energy.